Today,
we're going to do a 3-minute lowdown on the CallStranger vulnerability that came out earlier in June of this year. Much respect to the Turkish cyber researcher Yunus Çetirci for the discovery. This vulnerability affects the Universal Plug and Play, or UPnP protocol, affecting potentially billions of devices, and maybe even the ones on your home network. So, what is Universal Plug and Play? It's a protocol that allows devices like printers, Xboxes, computers, cameras, TVs, and other gadgets to automatically discover one another and open up ports on your router to be accessible from the public internet. Super convenient, right? Well, it sounds great until you realize that UPnP itself is wide open for abuse, helping attackers discover and hack devices around the world. Last year, we saw the first large-scale attack from the Mirai botnet, scanning hundreds of thousands of routers, searching for exposed telnet ports that probably got added by UPnP when users installed new IoT devices that needed these ports open. The attackers later brute-forced the default credentials to these devices, many of them IP cameras, and added them to the botnet. This time, rather than universal plug and play, helping punch holes into your home network, it's the very hole itself. CallStranger works by letting the attacker send special UPnP subscribe requests to elicit callbacks to the device itself directed anywhere. Here's three ways this can be really bad. First, attackers can use the vulnerability to port scan devices sitting behind your router on your internal network. Not just the outside, they can discover more UPnP-enabled devices or map out vulnerabilities on these endpoints. It's like a burglar who used to only have Google Street View of your home, but now has Google Indoor View on the inside of your house too. With potentially billions of local network devices around the world, attackers can also create reflected or amplified DDoS attacks by sending these requests to millions of internet-facing devices vulnerable to CallStranger. Attackers can trigger a storm of web requests pointed at a single target, taking down websites and servers from the overload of traffic. A third potential abuse is using these devices as mules to exfiltrate data from an organization's network. Once an attacker hacks into your network, he can have a universal plug-and-play device like a printer forward any stolen data out of the network to a command and control server. So, what should you do about this in the meantime? If you have a home network with universal plug-and-play enabled on devices, make sure your home router isn't port forwarding to them so they aren't exposed to the internet. Otherwise, the device could be used as a participant in DDoS attacks. You could also do everyone a favor and disable universal plug-and-play on your home router through its administration portal and learn how to manually configure your network devices at home. If you're an IT administrator or cyber analyst at work, you should close UPnP ports and internet-facing devices if there's no business need. Then block HTTP traffic containing the subscribe or notify commands with a web proxy or application firewall as an extra measure. If you do need UPnP for some devices, check their internet access and monitor your network logs to see if adversaries have used CallStranger against you. Yunus set up a great website at callstranger.com that gives you more information about this vulnerability. He's also written a Python tool on GitHub that lets you check to see if devices on your network are vulnerable to this UPnP flaw. In this case, the tool didn't find any verified devices vulnerable to CallStranger for me, but it's definitely worth checking your network if that's really the case. So that's it for the Cyberspatial News Update. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.